We might start with a positive. Not for the authorities, of course, and look at prison escapes that went marvelously right. We might remember one of the greatest escapes of all time, and that was because it involved three men breaking out of Alcatraz prison. They went missing in 1962, and still no one knows if they survived or died in the waters of San Francisco Bay. Then you have the final escape of Henri Charrière, aka Papillion, which involved sailing away on a makeshift raft. Or what about the numerous, incredibly cunning escapes of the serial killer scoundrel Charles Sobhraj, a man who we've talked about already at length? More recently, we saw the brazen escape of the gangster Joaquin Guzman Loria, aka El Chapo, but like many escapees, he was recaptured. Let's now look at failed escapes. The hapless hitcher. Obviously, once you've managed to escape from jail or prison, you should be careful who you talk to, as suspicion from another might land you right back in jail. In 2018, the BBC reported that 31-year-old Alan Lewis was being taken from Greenup County Detention Center in Kentucky, USA, when he told officers that his handcuffs were too tight and were hurting him. As an officer tried to help Lewis after a short struggle, he made a run for it. Freedom at last, but the man was stuck on a highway and needed a ride. In desperation, he held out his thumb, and a kind driver stopped for him. Except the driver noticed that Lewis was trying to hide what seemed like handcuffs fastened to one wrist. It turned out that the man driving the car was a police officer himself. Lewis got a ride right back to jail. The authorities later said he thought he was getting a ride, and he did. You might call this guy a chancer, but we'll get around to some hardcore criminals who orchestrated amazing escape attempts. An explosive letter writer. This is yet another failed prison attempt in 2018. This time it involved a man called Sean Damon Castorina, and he was trying to break out of Alamance County Detention Center in Graham, North Carolina. Serving time for first-degree murder, Castorina wouldn't have been released for quite some time, so he tried to figure out how he might get out a bit faster. His cunning plan to expedite his sentence was to build an explosive and blast his way out. Well, he needed help for that, so he wrote a letter to two of his friends with information about how to make a bomb and which prison wall they would blast, near to where Castorina would be waiting. What could possibly go wrong? Well, he sent that letter with bomb-making information to the wrong address, and it was picked up by a regular sort of person who subsequently informed the authorities. The media later wrote, "He has now been charged with 4 counts of felony conspiracy, 2 counts of manufacture or assemble a weapon of mass destruction, and 1 count of attempted escape from jail." Reading between the lines. Be careful what you say when planning a prison escape, even if you think your words are coded. In 2010, a 67-year-old prisoner at the Isle of Wight's Parker's Prison in the UK thought he would send a message to the outside via a letter. In the letter, these words were written, "More heat, less light." It sounds innocuous, but guards that were monitoring all the prison mail became suspicious. It turned out that this former science teacher had been hatching a plot to escape from what some people have called the British version of Alcatraz. Seeing that the prisoner had written "more heat" in one letter, the guards heated up some of his correspondence. This revealed that he'd been using dried lemon juice to write down his escape plans. The heat showed he'd sketched detailed maps of the prison, while messages were conveyed using encrypted code and messages hidden in Sudoku puzzles. He was also planning to use a helicopter to pick him up in part of the prison where he could land. He was found out. Later, the prison governor said, "I am delighted at the way our security team and Hampshire Constabulary have foiled a possible escape attempt." He was then moved to another prison, but reports state that none of his accomplices were arrested. Love won't tear us apart. This one should be a Hollywood movie, if it's not already and we don't know about it. It's the story of a woman called Barbara Ann Oswald. In 1978, she hijacked a helicopter that she had chartered, except she didn't count on the pilot being an ex-Vietnam vet. She put a gun to his head and told him to head to the United States Penitentiary, Marion in Illinois. She was trying to help inmate Garrett B. Trapnell, a con man, career criminal, and air pirate. Oswald was the lover of Trapnell, and the two had planned to get married. She didn't get very far as the pilot of the helicopter wrestled the gun from her and shot her in the head. That was the end of her and the end of the escape attempt, but the plot thickened. The daughter of Oswald was convinced that Trapnell was her father. He wasn't, and she very much wanted to get him out. She was only 17 years old when she hijacked TWA Flight 541 just months after her mother had died in the attempt to get Trapnell out. The brave daughter held the 80-something passengers for hours and flew to another location with about 40 passengers. She said she had dynamite strapped to her chest, but the three sticks turned out to be flares. She was finally arrested. Trapnell, who had hijacked a flight himself in the past, said there was no way that the young Oswald was his daughter. He'd never even met her mother face to face. Lord couldn't keep his mouth shut. Over in Australia, three hardened criminals who were all serving long sentences for drug trafficking got the idea to hire an SAS soldier living in the Philippines to get them out of prison in Melbourne. Except a man called Lord Tony Monaghan got in the way. Don't let the title Lord fool you. This man had once run a brothel. He had trafficked drugs himself, and he later grassed on others to reduce his own time in prison. One of the people he grassed on was the man known as Mr. Nice, aka Howard Marks, the Oxford-educated global pot trafficker who later became a celebrity of sorts. Anyway, so our Lord told the authorities that he had learned that three Aussies had hired an SAS guy to land on the tennis courts of the prison in a helicopter and break them out. He also said once they were dropped off, they would be taken in a van to Sydney and they would board a yacht and sail into the sunset. None of that happened, as the cops just waited for the men to wait on the tennis court and then arrested them during the escape attempt. Again, this could be a movie, and one of the guys who tried to escape had been featured in books. His name was David McMillan, another well-to-do Brit who speaks the Queen's English, but trafficked drugs for a living. He not only became one of the world's biggest smugglers, but he is the only man ever to have escaped from Thailand's notorious Klong Prim Central Prison. He wrote a book about this called Escape, saying because conditions were so brutal in Thai prisons, and the fact that he'd get death likely reduced to life, he had no choice but to get out early. The human stain. Okay, back to criminals we might not label with the epithet mastermind. In recent years, you can see that quite a few prisoners in Brazil have successfully escaped from prison by crawling into and out of the sewers. This can be a messy business, of course, but one can imagine the smell of feces can be put up with when the sweet smell of freedom is just around the corner. But back in 2016, things didn't go as planned for one fella. You can find a video of him online being pulled back out of a clogged sewer in what the media only said was a Sao Paulo prison. The video shows the captured man later standing in his cell, his skin painted brown, a coating the Telegraph newspaper called Human Filth. Current status: on the run. All of you out there know very well that if you were ever to successfully break out of jail or prison, then the next best thing is to probably keep your head down, right? We mean, you wouldn't post a photo on Facebook of your free face. No way. And you certainly wouldn't post a picture of your free head and not do anything about that globe icon that ensures anyone can see this picture. Well, CBS News in 2010 reported that a man called Chris Grego did just that, and he was warned by police. This one is perhaps a bit of a cheat, as Grego managed to evade cops before he was actually sentenced for assault, so it's more of an escape from law than a prison break. We just like the story. While Grego was out, he kept updating his Facebook page, and so the cops didn't have to try very hard to find him. Grego had even shown off, posting his own wanted poster on his page. One of the arresting officers told the press, "If it wasn't for criminals like him, our job would be a lot harder." Almost perfect, 9 out of 10. Sometimes we can be brilliant and occasionally we just fall at the last hurdle. That's fine, at least we got to that hurdle. But in this case, you might wonder if the guy could have pushed himself just a little bit further. His name was Robert Emery, and he was locked up at Oregon State Prison in 2010. The Oregonian newspaper tells us that this hardworking man broke windows, drilled out a door lock, broke into metal tool cages, bashed a hole in the laundry well, lugged bags of tools, dug under one fence, and climbed over another. He'd also left a dummy in his cell, something we often see in movies. The media reports that he had spent time making this figure so it would look just like a real sleeping person. It had been a physically demanding night, and the news tells us that Emery wasn't just tired, but he was bleeding too. Emery, then 50 and serving time for robbery, kidnapping, and assault, after being hurt on the razor wire fence and then just decided to catch a few Z's, got under a blanket and went to sleep in the yard. Some reports, perhaps bordering on clickbait, state he fell asleep as he was just so tired. More responsible media, however, say he actually gave up as he could not scale the razor wire fence. Watch your weight. While you could argue that it isn't the worst prison in history of the world, the Tower of London evokes nightmarish pictures of bodies being torn apart on the rack, of hellish screams coming from dark chambers, of cruel leaders leaving anyone they disliked there irrespective of any crime being committed. But people escaped, and as late as the 20th century when a man picked a lock with a spoon. In the early 18th century, the Earl of Nithsdale dressed up as a woman and managed to get past guards. For that trickery, he saved his own head. In the 16th century, Jesuits John Girard and John Arden performed the tried and tested rope over the wall thing and managed to lower themselves down to freedom. It's said that they did this with mangled hands, a punishment hors d'oeuvre before they were really hurt. But this is not a show about success, and we must tell you about Gruffydd ap Llywelyn, the son of a Welsh king back in the 12th and 13th centuries. He was imprisoned in the Tower of London after some disagreement with the King of England, with the latter not keeping his end of the bargain. It's said the king put Gruffydd up as a guest in the tower, but the Welshman wasn't keen on the idea. In 1244, he made a rope out of cloth and bits of sheets, and he tried to lower himself out of a window. His makeshift rope snapped. We're told he was a portly man, and he fell to his death. And that's all we have for you. Can you add to this list? Which one is your favorite? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other show, Man So Violent Even Other Prisoners Fear Him. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.